Okay, now let's see the load line analysis. So this is the common emitter connection, as you have seen in the previous video. We can see when there is no signal or no signal is applied from the base side, you can see that this is the only circuit that exists, and you can get the formula of VCE. I mean VCC is equal to ICRC plus VCE. This is the load line analysis equation, and this is when plotted in between VCE and IC, you will get a straight line. Finding the first point, when IC is equal to zero, you will get that VCE is equal to VCC, which is the maximum value that can be formed by VCE is VCC. So that gives the first point. And second point, we take like VCE is equal to zero. So for finding IC, VCC is going to the other side, we can see that maximum IC is equal to VCC by RC. That is the maximum IC point. And you can get the two points of the line, and you get a line equation. And then for operation point, that means the Q point, where this line as well as the required IB value, the constant IB value meets, is called as Q point. That is the operating point. So referring IB is equal to 5 microamperes. When it is 5 microamperes, according to that, you have to find, you can find IC by IC is equal to beta IB. Then with the substituting IC value in the VC is equal to VCC minus ICRC equation, you can get the VCE value. Next, let's move on to op amp, the operational amplifier. Op amp is basically a multi-stage amplifier. It uses a number of amplifiers, means transistors, stage interconnected to each other using resistor and capacitor. The advantages of op amp IC is small size, high reliability, low cost, and less power consumption. Op amp amplifies an input signal and produces output voltage, so which is equal to the difference between two input terminals multiplied by voltage gain. You can see that VO is equal to A into V1 minus V2, the difference, and into voltage gain. Op amp is called as operational amplifier because it can do addition, subtraction, and multiplication with signals. Then the characteristics of op amp is it has very high differential gain. A value is very large, high input impedance, RIN is very high, R out is very low, low output impedance, provide voltage change, amplitude, polarity, all changes, and uses in oscillator filter and many instrumentations. Accumulate a very high gain by multiple stages. There are multiple stages here, just it is an figurative thing, but there are multiple transistors that are used here, and the gain ultimately goes up to 10^5. These are the parameters for IC741C, and it is very important in terms of objective part, and definitely there would be questions from this part. So then let's move on to points to remember. Gain A is equal to amplifier output by amplifier input, X naught by XI, either current or voltage, whatever it might be. This is the formula to be used. And for ideal op amp, when input is equal to V1 is equal to V2 is equal to 0, then output V0 must be 0. As you can see here, V1 0, V2 0, then V0 must be 0. But in practical op amp, V0 is not equal to 0. The magnitude of the output voltage when input V1 is equal to V2 is equal to 0 is called an output offset voltage of the op amp. When that V0 value, which is not equal to 0, that is called the output offset voltage, and this is due to the input transistors have different VBE values. And here this is the linearity of gain when the x values are x input values are smaller and the difference is smaller, the output gain is very large, you can see here. But when the input values are large in size, the output values are very small. When I mean the difference and things. Thank you.